that shows that he was a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, if I have someone, I take care of him, then he get married, he's not my son, he's not my biological son, none of that. If he got married, then he divorced his wife, afterward, I'm allowed to marry him. And there's no problem with that, because they knew in the Old Testament, there's a prophet who will come in that place. That's why they travel to that place, Medina. But before we come to that, so now, there, Prophet Muhammad went to them, he surrounded them. They say, we'll not be happy with anyone's judgment except to Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. Who Sa'd ibn Mu'ad? He was their allies before. Sa'd ibn Mu'ad, he said, oh, Prophet Muhammad, do you accept me to be a judge over them? He said, they chose you.
And he became a Muslim. At the time, he was a Muslim.
Yeah.
But prior to that, he was from the Jewish tribes.
Yeah.
So they chose him to be the person who was judged in the FA.
Some people are saying he was Jewish, some people saying he wasn't.
The man from the man, Irish puberty, and the other one who killed them as a war captive, yeah? But did you know that law is in the Bible? That's read in the Bible. That's why, as our brother Abu Iyad, one of our teachers, mentioned, he said the law that was mentioned by Mu'ad, according to the Torah. Let us read words in the Torah that you, if you enter a town, what you should do to them.
Okay.
The Christians, that'll never mentioned that.
This will be my homework this evening. Deuteronomy 20, that'll be my homework.
Yeah, homework. So this is Deuteronomy. Yeah, Deuteronomy. But now let us read out what the Jewish historian said about how the Islam defended Prophet Muhammad, how Prophet Muhammad and the Islam defended Jews. This is, you can go do another homework. This subhanAllah, our brother Abu Iyad, Hafidhahullah, said it to me yesterday. You know, this Jew, you know, his name, Professor David J. Was that Westerin, yeah? So he's a professor in Vanderbilt University in USA. He said Islam saved
David
J.
Westerin.
Jewish. You can do your own homework. For the people that are watching, they do homework.
We'll see the name again.
His name, Professor David J. Was that Westerin, yeah? So he's a professor in Vanderbilt University in USA. He said Islam saved David J. Jewish. You can do your own homework. For the people that are watching, they do homework. But what he said, Islam saved Jews. This is an unpopular, this converting claim in the modern world, but it is historical truth. The argument for it is double. First, in 570 CE, when the Prophet Muhammad was born, the Jews and Judaism were on the way to oblivion. And the second, the coming of Islam, saved them, providing a new context in which they not only survived, but flourished. Not just.